Good day, Hagerstown Tigers. Thank you for joining us on this lovely first Friday of the holiday season. With the holiday season in full swing, all of us here at the studio wish you the warmest, wackiest, wholesome time with the wonderful and wild wizard of Christmas that is Santa Claus. Coming up, as always, a report of current and upcoming Tiger events, B-balling with the boys, a trip around the globe, a peek into Tiger athletics, and the latest on weather. Stay tuned for this week's episode of The Studio.
Fast approaching, and the push to winter break is reaching its last stretch. If you haven't been informed, the finals week schedule is up on your daily announcements. We wish the best of luck to our students during testing in the next couple of weeks. As you have probably seen, this year's snowball flyers have been posted all around the school. They have all the information you need to know about the winter event, and if you somehow miss them, the digital flyer is in your daily announcements. Donations are being accepted through December 13th for the FCCLA Random Acts of Kindness campaign. Please bring donations to Mrs. Hobson's room and leave your name on a sticky note with the items you brought in. The complete list of recommended items are in your announcements.
With pancreatic cancer being one of the deadliest cancers out there, scientists are happy to report that the molecule PJ34 has been shown to reduce cancer cells 90 to 100% when testing mice. The report gives researchers hope of making a human cure with enough time and testing. Coffee lovers, this news is for you. Air New Zealand is making an effort to reduce its waste by replacing traditional coffee cups with edible versions. The airline serves more than 8 million cups of coffee each year. After enjoying their hot cup of coffee, air travelers can eat the vessels made of vanilla-flavored biscotti. I don't know about you, but pumpernickel sounds like a delectable flavor. In Dresden, Germany, a heist at the Grenes Gewölbe Museum has resulted in several priceless items being stolen. A small diamond-encrusted sword and a necklace bearing 177 pearls are among the items stolen. A little less than 20 items were taken from the museum after two unidentified people came in through smashing a window. The alleged criminals then axed a few display cases to steal certain jewels. The item the museum once returned most is a 41-carat diamond shoulder piece with a 39-carat and 21-carat diamond on either side. The museum is offering a 500,000 euro reward. And now to Mason for fact or fiction.
Man, that was really cool. Also, I felt like I've gotten a lot better at basketball in the past few weeks.
Dude, me too. I hit this crazy trick shot the other day. You should have seen it. I was standing at half court, and I did a 360 behind the back, and shot it, made it right in the goal swish.
No way, that's insane, man. Last week I was riding an alligator, and I just like threw it between my legs, and it bounced off the ground, and it just swooshed. It was insane.
Dude, I think we're probably the best trick shotters in the land.
I don't think you're the best in the land. In fact, you might be the worst.
Nah. So we set out to hit the best trick shots we can to see if we were indeed the best trick shotters in the land. You're watching Boys Perfect.
This one's called Dinner Served.
Would you give my heart to a god? But which one?
This is called the Senora Special.
This is the issue.
Ball 78 kilos is at a 129 degree angle. I'm gonna travel 6.5 miles and apply about 67,000 Kelvin to get some money. What do you think the odds are that I make this?
I'm going less than 1%. I don't think we have much chance at all. But yeah, let's see.
Let's get a shot.
The JV and varsity boys basketball teams play Richmond tonight at Richmond. JV starts at 6 and varsity will play afterwards. The JV and varsity girls basketball teams play at Eastern Hancock tomorrow. JV will start at 12 and varsity will play afterwards. Also tomorrow, the wrestling team will be hosting an invitational beginning at 9 a.m. Winter conditioning for track has started and will take place on Mondays, Tuesdays, Wednesdays, and Thursdays. Practices will not go past 5 p.m. We hope to see you all out supporting our Tiger teams this weekend.
This evening calls for partly cloudy skies, breaking today's cloudy trend. Despite the clouds, the high for today should stay in the mid to lower 40s until sunset. Saturday will be sunny from sunrise to sunset, with temperatures slowly rising to the lower 40s. Sunday will be cloudy throughout the entire day, yet will have the highest temperatures of the weekend with a high of 50. Follow your heart and ask someone to snowball.
Thank you for tuning into this week's episode of The Studio. Jack asked me to say a few words about one of our very own Tigers and my best friend, Bailey Four. Bailey suffered a stroke last Saturday and has been at Peyton Manning Children's Hospital since. Though this was very unexpected, she is slowly but surely recovering and returning to her normal, hilarious self. You can show your support by buying an all-for-one, one-for-all shirt like the one I'm wearing, where half of the proceeds go towards hospital and travel expenses for her family. There will also be a GoFundMe link on the screen that you can visit to donate. Enjoy your weekend, and we'll see you right here next week on The Studio. Don't let me down. I'ma forget.